Hello students, I am Manoj Kundare, the assistant professor of electronic science. Welcome back to our e-learning platform. In previous video, we have seen the concept of Wien bridge oscillator. The link of the previous video is available in the description box. Please check it. Now, in this video, we are going to see the concept of the crystal oscillator. Let's start our today's topic, the crystal oscillator. A crystal oscillator is an electronic oscillator circuit that is used for the mechanical resonance of a vibrating crystal of piezoelectric material. It will create an electrical signal with a given frequency. Crystal oscillator operate on the principle of inverse photopiezoelectric effect, in which alternating voltage applied across the crystal surfaces causes it vibrate at its natural frequency. That means a crystal oscillator is made up of a piezoelectric crystal, and the piezoelectric crystal has a specific effect named as the piezoelectric effect, and the crystal oscillator works on the inverse principle of the piezoelectric effect. First of all, we have to know what is meant by piezoelectric effect. Let's see. Consider a piezoelectric crystal here. This is a piece of piezoelectric crystal. The piezoelectric crystal generally made up of the material like tourmaline or quartz, etc., or Rochelle salt. If this is the piezoelectric crystal, and if we apply a mechanical force or pressure between these two faces, then the electrical potential will develop across at its two terminal. That means if we apply force in that direction, like in this direction, then the electrical potential will be developed across its opposite faces. This is known as the piezoelectric effect. And the inverse piezoelectric effect states that if across a crystal we apply the electric potential, that means the supply, positive and negative, then this crystal starts vibrating. This crystal starts vibrating at its axis. This vibrating frequency or this vibration is when equal to the natural frequency of the oscillator. When the vibration frequency is equal to the natural frequency of the oscillator, then this crystal vibrates with the maximum capacity. That means we can say that the crystal is vibrating at its resonating frequency. This is known as the inverse piezoelectric effect, and this effect is used in the crystal oscillator circuit. It is these vibrations which eventually get converted into the oscillations. These oscillators are usually made up of quartz crystal, even though other substances like Rochelle salt, tourmaline exhibits the piezoelectric effect. Okay, now let's see short details about the crystal or the crystal circuit. Here in crystal oscillators, the crystal is suitably cut and mounted between two metallic plates as shown by figure 1A. Here the crystal oscillator is shown, in which it is placed between the two metallic plates, okay, and whose electrical equivalent circuit is shown by figure 1B. This is the electrical equivalent circuit of the crystal oscillator, in which we can see here that this equivalent circuit contains the capacitor, inductor and resistor connected in series with each other, and this combination of series is connected in parallel with the capacitance Cp. Okay. In reality, the crystal behaves like the series RLC circuit formed by the components a low valued resistor RS, a large valued inductor LS and a small valued capacitor CS, which will be in parallel with the capacitance of these electrodes Cp. I hope you all understand the basic equivalent circuit of the quartz crystal. Now let's see more details about it. Due to the presence of Cp, the The crystal will resonate at two different frequencies, which are: the first one is the series resonant frequency FS, which occurs when the series capacitance CS, that means this capacitance CS, resonates with the series inductance LS, that means this capacitor is resonates with the inductor, and at this stage the crystal impedance will be the least. That means when the CS resonates with LS, then the crystal impedance is least, okay, and hence the amount of feedback will be largest. Mathematical expression for the same is given as Fs is equal to 1 upon 2 pi under root LS CS. And the second frequency is the parallel resonant frequency FP, which exhibit when the reactance of LS CS legs, that means LS CS legs, equal to the reactance of the parallel capacitor CP, that is LS and CS resonates with CP. When LS and CS resonate with CP, then at that instant the crystal impedance will be highest, and hence if the crystal impedance is highest, then the feedback will be least. The mathematical expression for the parallel resonant frequency FP is given by the equation 1 upon 2 pi under root LS CP CS upon CP plus CS. Okay, this is the mathematical equation, and we only refer here the formula, not the total derivation here. Okay, this is the frequency response of the crystal equivalent circuit. The frequency response of crystal is shown below. The graph shows the reactance and the frequency. The x-axis represents the frequency, while the y-axis represents the reactance. It is evident that the crystal has two closely spaced resonant frequency. This part represents the series frequency, and this part represents the parallel frequency. Okay. Now let's see our today's topic, the crystal oscillator circuit. A crystal oscillator circuit can be constructed in number of ways, like a crystal controlled tune collector oscillator, Colpitts crystal oscillator, a clap crystal oscillator, etc. But the transistor Peirce crystal oscillator is the most commonly used one. This is the circuit which is normally referred as the crystal oscillator circuit. Okay, that means out of these crystal oscillators, the transistor Peirce crystal oscillator circuit is most commonly used, and generally it is known as the crystal oscillator circuit. The circuit diagram shows the arrangement of transistor Peirce crystal oscillator circuit. This is the circuit diagram for the crystal oscillator circuit, in which we can see that the transistor is connected, the input is applied to the base of the transistor, output is taken at the collector, and the crystal is connected between the output and the input. That means the crystal is connected in the feedback path. Okay, I hope you all understand the circuit arrangement here. Now let's see more details about the circuit. In this circuit, the crystal is connected as a series element in the feedback path from the collector to the base. We know that the collector is the output terminal and base is the input terminal, and the connection between output to the input is referred as the feedback path. In this feedback path, the crystal oscillator is connected. Okay. The resistors R1, R2 and RE, that means R1, R2 and RE, provide the voltage divider stabilized DC bias circuit. That means this arrangement R1, R2 and RE is used as the voltage divider arrangement, which gives constant supply to the base terminal. The capacitor CE, that means this capacitor CE provides AC bypass of the emitter resistor, and RFC, radio frequency choke coil, provides this RFC provides for the DC bias while decoupling any AC signal on the power lines from affecting the output signal. The coupling capacitor C, that means the coupling capacitor C has negligible impedance at the circuit operating frequency, but it blocks any DC between collector and base. Okay, we already know this type of connection, and we seen this type of circuit in the previous chapter also. Okay, I hope you all remember these things. The circuit frequency of oscillation is set by the series resonant frequency of the crystal and its value given by the relation F0 equal to 1 upon under root 2 pi 1 upon 2 pi under root LC. Okay, it may be noted that the changes in the supply voltage, transistor device parameters, etc. have no effect on the circuit operating frequency, which is held stabilized by the crystal. That means the other effect like temperature or the changes in supply voltage does not affect the output frequency. Okay, I hope you all understand the crystal oscillator here. Now let's see the advantages of the crystal oscillator. They have a high order of frequency stability. The quality factor Q of the crystal is very high in case of crystal oscillator. There are some disadvantages of crystal oscillator, such as they are fragile and can be used in low power circuits, and the frequency of oscillations cannot be changed appreciably. Okay, now let's see the difference between RCLC and crystal oscillator. In RC oscillator, the frequency of oscillations is dependent on the value of R and C. In LC oscillator, the frequency of oscillations depends on the value of L and C. And in crystal oscillator, the frequency of oscillations depend on the dimensions of the crystal. In RC oscillator, these are used at low and medium frequencies. The LC oscillators are preferred at high frequencies, while the crystal oscillators are preferred at very high frequencies. The example of RC oscillators are phase shift Wien bridge oscillator, Hartley-Colpitts and Kullup oscillator, and the example of crystal oscillator is that Miller crystal oscillator and Peirce crystal oscillator. Okay, the frequency stability of RC oscillator is poor, while in LC oscillator the poor frequency stability except for the Kullup oscillator, and in crystal oscillator very high frequency stability. In RC oscillator, it is used as low and medium frequency signal generators. The LC oscillators are used in radio, TV as high frequency resource frequency synthesizers, and the crystal oscillator used as the crystal clocks, synthesizer, special type of receivers. These are the applications of the crystal oscillator. I hope you all understand the basic difference between RC, LC and crystal oscillator. Thank you.